holds the notion of leakage region zero knowledge, which is a notion of zero knowledge against the verifiers who obtain the leakage of the provable secret state. So in particular, leakage region zero knowledge is defined by considering verifiers who make any leakage query during the protocol. So the verifier can query any function at any time of the protocol, and after the query, the function is evaluated immediately on the current state of the provable state, and the output is returned to the verifier. And of course, the verifier can query any number of queries, and these queries can be made adaptively. Okay, so more formally, leakage region zero knowledge is defined as follows. So for any cheating verifiers who can query any leakage query, we require that there exists a simulator that can simulate a cheating verifier's view, including the answer to the leakage query. So the simulator is required to simulate the leakage for the cheating verifier. However, since we consider cheating verifier who can query any leakage query, the verifier can request leakage from the witness of that prover has. And then, in this case, the simulator can, of course, cannot simulate leakage because it doesn't have any information about the witness. So, in the definition of leakage region zero knowledge, we consider a simulator that can obtain some information about the witness by making query to an oracle called the leakage oracle. So, leakage oracle is parameterized by the witness that prover has, and it evaluates any function on the witness and returns the output to the simulator. So in the setting of leakage region zero knowledge, the goal of the simulator is to simulate a cheating verifier view, including leakage, by obtaining some information about the witness from the leakage oracle. And I know that in order to make sure that this definition guarantees meaningful security, we require that the simulator obtain at most the same amount of the leakage as the verifier. So we require that if the cheating verifier obtain L bit of the leakage by making the leakage query, then the simulator can obtain at most L bit of the leakage from a leakage oracle. Okay. Then, in the previous work, in the work by Gago et al., they show that we can construct a leakage region zero knowledge protocol if we use a relaxed definition. So in particular, they consider a definition in which the simulator can obtain a slightly more amount of the leakage than the verifier, and they show that we can construct a protocol under such a definition. And the round complexity of the protocol is at least omega log n. And the assumption they use is a statistically hiding commitment with a public coin property. And it is known that such a commitment can be based on any one-way function. Then, in a recent work by Pandey, the result of Gago et al. Was improved. And in particular, Pandey shows that we can construct leakage region zero knowledge without relaxing the definition. So Pandey constructs a protocol using the definition that I explained in the previous slide. And Pandey also improves the result of Gago et al. In terms of the round complexity. And in particular, Pandey's protocol has only a constant number of rounds. However, these improvement comes with the cost of the assumption, and in particular, Pandey uses DDH assumption and the existence of a collision-resistant hash function to prove the security of his protocol. So, of course, both the DDH assumption and the existence of a collision-resistant hash function are quite standard, and there's no problem of using them in practice. But, however, in a theoretical perspective, it is important to determine what is the weakest possible assumption to construct a primitive. And in that perspective, The use of the assumption is not so very good in the protocol, in the work of Fande, because the DDA assumption is seemingly much stronger than the existence of a collision research function or a one-way function. So in this work, I consider the problem of removing the DDH assumption from the result of Pandey. So the goal of this work is to construct a leakage region zero knowledge protocol by assuming only the existence of collision resistance hash function. OK. So now let me state the result of this work. So in this work, I prove the following theorem. So assume the existence of a collision resistance hash function. Then there exists a constant lambda public coin leakage region zero knowledge argument for any language in NP. So compared with the previous work, this work achieves the same security and the same lambda complexity. And at the same time, this work uses a weaker assumption. And in particular, we use only the collision resistance hash function, and so DDA assumption is no longer used. Okay. And I also want to know that even though this work uses a weaker assumption, the protocol of this work satisfies an additional property called the leakage region soundness, which is a soundness against a cheating prover who obtains an unbounded amount of the leakage from a verifier's secret state. So leakage region soundness alone is not so hard to satisfy. And actually, any public coin zero knowledge is already leakage region sound. However, satisfying both leakage region zero knowledge and leakage region soundness is not so easy. And in particular, previous leakage region zero knowledge doesn't satisfy leakage region soundness. So the protocol of this work is the first one that satisfies leakage region zero knowledge and the leakage region soundness simultaneously. OK. So this work uses a weaker assumption and provides a protocol that satisfies stronger security in the leakage setting. OK. So this is a result of this work. So in the rest of this talk, let me explain the technique of this work. So first, let me explain the basic simulated strategy in the setting of leakage region zero knowledge. And in particular, I want to note that in order to prove leakage region zero knowledge, it suffices to consider a simulator who simulates the prover's message and the prover's randomness simultaneously. So recall that in the definition of leakage region zero knowledge, the simulator is required to simulate a cheating verifier's view, including the answer to the leakage oracle, leakage query. So the simulator has to simulate the prover's message and leakage for the cheating verifier. However, it is easy to see that if the simulator can simulate the prover's randomness, then the simulator can easily simulate the leakage for cheating verifier by just forwarding the leakage query from the cheating verifier to the leakage oracle, with the simulated randomness being hardwired as the input of the function. So in order to prove leakage region zero knowledge, it suffices to consider a simulator who simulates prover's message and randomness. And so we construct a protocol such that prover's message and randomness can be simulated. Then I construct a leakage region zero knowledge protocol in the following two steps. So in the first step, I construct a main tool, which is a new instance-based equivocal commitment that satisfies not only equivocality, but also a nice leakage region property. And I construct such a commitment by using only one-way function. Then in the second step, I use this instance-based equivocal commitment to construct the leakage region zero knowledge protocol. Okay. And I will explain both of these steps, and let me first explain the first steps. So recall that the instance-based equivocal commitment is a commitment scheme that is based on an NP instance, such that when the instance is false, then the commitment is binding. But when the instance is true, then the commitment is equivocal, and in particular, a commitment can be opened to both 0 and 1 by using a witness for the instance. Then, in this work, I construct a new instance-based equivocal commitment by converting the leakage region zero knowledge protocol of Gago et al. To an instance-based equivocal commitment. So in particular, since the leakage region zero knowledge of Gago et al. Is based on the Brahms-Hamiltonian zero knowledge, all I did here is just to use a well-known technique that converts Brahms-Hamiltonian zero knowledge to an instance-based equivocal commitment. And a nice thing here is that since our instance-based equivocal commitment is based on the leakage region zero knowledge of Gago et al., our equivocal commitment inherits a leakage region property from the protocol of Gago et al. So in the next slide, I will explain this property. So, okay, so roughly speaking, our equivocal commitment satisfies the following property. So consider a three-round protocol between the prover and the verifier, in which the prover commits to zero using our equivocal commitment. And then, after receiving a bit B from the verifier, it opens the commitment to B using equivocality. Then, the nice property of our equivocal commitment guarantees that we can simulate the prover's message and randomness of this protocol, as long as we can predict the value of B in advance. So I know that this property is not so simple, and it is not clear if this property is really nice or not. But the important thing is that this property says that we can simulate the prover's message randomness of our equivocal commitment as long as we know our equivocal commitment just as in this commit-then equivocate protocol. So this means that if we can construct a zero-knowledge protocol by using our equivocal commitment just as in this protocol, then we can show that we can simulate the prover's message randomness of such a protocol, and so we can conclude the leakage region zero knowledgeness. So now our goal is to construct a leakage region zero. Our goal is to construct a zero knowledge protocol by using our equivocal commitment just as in this protocol. Okay. So now let me explain our leakage region zero knowledge protocol. Okay. So in our protocol, we use so-called Barak's preamble, which is a preamble stage of the Barak's non-black box zero knowledge. So the detail of Barak's preamble is not needed for this talk, and what is needed is the fact that after the preamble, the prover and the verifier obtain a statement called the trapdoor statement. And it is guaranteed that any cheating prover cannot make the trapdoor statement true, but there exists a simulator who can make the trapdoor statement true and obtain a witness for it by using the code of the verifier. Okay. And I know that actually in this work, I need to modify the Barak's preamble so that it can be used in the leakage setting, but in this talk, I ignore this fact. Okay. Then, using Barak's preamble, I construct a leakage region protocol as follows. So basically, our leakage region zero knowledge protocol is a Hamiltonian zero knowledge protocol, in which the graph is committed by using our equivocal commitment, which is based on the which is based on the statement X, and also the statement to be proven in trapped statement is the false, is the trapped statement that is generated by Barkov's preamble. So in our protocol, the prover and the verifier first execute the Barkov's preamble to obtain trapped statement, and then they execute the Bramuth-Hamiltonian zero knowledge in which the trapped statement is proven. Okay. Now, before showing the security of this protocol, let me first check the correctness of this protocol, meaning that the honest prover can prove the statement. So actually, the correctness of this protocol is not clear because the prover has to prove a trapped statement in Hamiltonian zero knowledge, but the trapped statement is false from the property of Barkov's preamble. So the key point here is that even though the trapped statement is false, the prover can still generate accepting Hamiltonian zero knowledge proof by simulating it by equivocation. So in particular, since the prover knows the witness for the real statement X, it can equivocate in the opening of our equivocal commitment. So it can generate accepting Hamiltonian zero knowledge proof by just committing zero matrix using our equivocal commitment, and then open the commitment to either random permutation of the trapped statement or random cycle, depending on the value of the challenge. Okay. So in this way, even though the prover have to prove a false statement, the correctness of our protocol still holds. So next, let me check the soundness. And actually, the soundness of our protocol follows almost immediately from the soundness of Hamiltonian zero knowledge. So in particular, since Barkov's preamble guarantees that the trapped statement is false for any cheating prover, the cheating prover has to prove a false statement in Hamiltonian zero knowledge. However, since in the setting of soundness, the statement X is false, our equivocal commitment is binding, and so using exactly the same argument as the soundness proof of Hamiltonian zero knowledge, we can show that the prover cannot prove a false statement in Hamiltonian zero knowledge, so we can conclude that our protocol is sound. Okay. So finally, I will explain the proof of leakage resistant zero knowledge. But before that, let me first explain the proof of soundness, a proof of zero knowledge as a warm-up. So here we consider a simulator who simulates the prover's message for the cheating verifier. So the key point here is that the simulator can generate accepting proof of a trapped statement by just proving trapped statement honestly. So in particular, the simulator can make the trapped statement true and obtain a witness for it in the Barkov's preamble. And so it can generate accepting Hamiltonian zero knowledge proof by just committing to a random permutation of the trapped statement in the first round, and then open the commitment to either the entire graph or the cycle in the graph by opening the commitment honestly. Okay. So in this way, it is easy to simulate the prover's message. And as I said earlier, in order to prove the leakage resistant zero knowledge, all we have to show now is to show that the simulator can also simulate the prover's randomness in addition to the prover's message. So in order to show that, we consider a hybrid experiment that is defined as followed. So in this hybrid experiment, just as in the real experiment, the prover commits to a zero matrix using our equivocal commitment and opens the commitment by using equivocality. However, in this experiment, instead of opening the commitment to either the random interpretation of the trapped statement or random cycle, the prover opens the commitment to either random permutation of the trapped statement or the cycle in that statement. And in order to do that, the prover makes the trapped statement true in the Barkov's preamble, just like the simulator in the previous slide. Okay. And it is not so hard to see that the verified view in this experiment is indistinguishable from the verified view in the previous in the real experiment. So all we have to show now is that we can simulate the verified view, including leakage, in this hybrid experiment. And in order to do that, it suffices to show that the prover's message and the randomness can be simulated in this hybrid experiment. Okay. And the key point here is that since in this hybrid experiment, the prover opens a commitment to either the entire graph or cycle in the graph, for each bit in the adjacent matrix of that graph, the prover does either commit then equivocate or commit then don't open. So in particular, when the challenge is zero, then the prover always does commit then equivocate. And when the challenge is one, then prover does commit then equivocate if the bit represents an edge on the cycle, and it does commit then don't open in other cases. Then we observe that if we can simulate the prover's message and randomness of commits and equivocate, we can trivially simulate the prover's message and randomness of both these cases. And so it remains to show is that we can simulate the prover's message and randomness of commit then equivocate. But this is exactly what the nice property of our equivocal commitment guarantee. So we can conclude the proof just by using the nice property. So this is a rough sketch of the proof. So for detail, please see the paper. OK, so let me conclude the talk. So in this work, I construct a leakage region zero knowledge protocol using a collision resistant hash function. And unlike previous work, we assume only the existence of a collision resistant hash function. And also, unlike previous work, we construct a protocol that satisfies both zero knowledgeness and soundness in the leakage setting. Okay. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much. We have time for a very quick question. No, so then let's go to lunch. Let's thank the speakers of the session.